shit go crazy.
What's going on, my good folks? It's your man, your guy, your boy, 1127 Kicks. I hope everybody out there is having a great day, an amazing day, and overall a blessed day. Say, man, if you're new to the channel, do your boy a huge favor. Hit that like button. Go ahead and subscribe to the page. And if you're already with the movement, bro, I greatly appreciate you, man. Hit that like button, share this video, and let's go ahead and keep this page growing. So, man, I've been seeing so many images of this shoe. We got, you know, I wouldn't say official images, but dang near, you could say we got official images of this shoe, man. We know what it's looking like. We know this shoe was coming out in November, man. And this might be up there with, you know, with them Game Royals. Because right now, the Game Royals, in my opinion, they got the crown as far as the best Air Jordan 1s of the year. And the shoe that I am talking about is these Air Jordan 1 Mocha joints right here, man. Now, I know this shoe is slated to release in November. I forgot what day in November, but I know it's going to be late November, you know, when the shoe actually dropped, which is, you know, your boy's birthday month. If I'm not mistaken, I believe it's November 23rd, and that's actually a day after my birthday. You feel what I'm saying? But anyway, so with this shoe right here, man, of course, a lot of people are calling it the poor man Travis Scott's. You know, they're saying that, you know, this is just a consolation prize if you don't got your Travis Scott's, da-da-da-da-da, talking all that nonsense. Like, people are not going to go out and cop this shoe, man. But let me keep it 100 with you off the rip before we even get into the shoe. I've personally owned the Travis Scott highs, man, and I love that shoe. Great quality. It looks way better in hand. But these mochas, though, these mochas definitely look better than those Travis Scott's, in my personal opinion. In the conversation below, let me know. Well, hype aside, let me know which one y'all think look better. Do y'all think these mochas look better than these Travis Scott's, or you think these Travis Scott's look better than these mochas? Just let me know in the comment section below. Now, if you think the Travis Scott's look better, it's all good. I ain't judging you or anything like that. I'm just letting y'all know I'm team mocha. You feel what I'm saying? So let's go ahead and get into the shoe real quick. Pretty much, this is like a black toe Air Jordan 1, man, except if you just replace the red, you know, with brown. That's pretty much what it is right there, man. And there you have it right there. You literally have a Mocha Air Jordan 1 that is slated to release in November for a retail price of $170. Now, one thing that I've noticed about this shoe is it looks like the toe box is leather around the toe box, but it looks like, you know, the brown back tab of the shoe, it looks like that is suede, you know, and that honestly is super dope to me right there. I think that's a nice little touch that they actually put on the shoe. And honestly, I feel like that's actually great marketing by Nike, because of course we all know that the Travis Scott Air Jordan 1s, you know, the brown on that shoe is suede, and with them putting that brown suede, you know, on this shoe, it's not the exact same color brown. I don't know if the suede is going to be as good as the Travis Scott Air Jordan 1s, but just for them to actually do something relatively close to that, I feel like that's super dope, man, because everybody's not going to have $1,000+ to actually get a Travis Scott, you know, and we don't know if, you know, if Jordan and Nike would ever retro the Air Jordan 1 Travis Scott's. And if they do, it's probably years and years and years down the line, to the point where, you know, it might be a generation who really don't know too much about the Travis Scott's, you know what I'm saying? So I feel like that's dope right there that they actually did this. And then on top of that, it was other images that was coming up with this shoe. And honestly, what I really wanted for these mochas, the same color blocking that you see on the Air Jordan 1 Travis Scott Lowe's, I was like, yo, if they give us that color blocking and an OG high, that would definitely be dope right there, man. I feel like it still would have sold out. I still feel like it would have did crazy numbers. But with them putting this black toe colorway on there, this shoe is definitely going to sell out. This shoe is definitely going to do numbers. This is not even a hold your shoe situation. I definitely feel like when this shoe drops, and this is my personal opinion, when this shoe drops, even though it's a retail price of $170, I feel like that this shoe will be $350+. I'm not even gonna lie. I feel like that the hype behind this shoe is that high. And then on top of that, it has that original black toe color blocking. Now, of course, you know, we've been getting those pine greens, the 1.0s, the core purple 1.0s, the Game Royals, the bread toes. Now, excuse me, all those pretty much have the black toe color blocking, except, you know, on the actual toe box, they have a specific color on there. But with these Mochas, I'm glad they didn't do it, because it might have looked awkward. They didn't put that brown on the toe box. They just left it white. So honestly, it's like a true, you know, OG Jordan 1 black toe color blocking when it comes to the shoe right here. And I honestly feel like, you know, that's super dope, and that's actually going to make the shoe even more highly sought after, in my personal opinion, man. Like, this shoe will definitely be trouble, and I'm looking forward to actually getting this shoe. I'm going to go ahead and speak into existence. That's my birthday month right there, man. So I want to go ahead, and I really want to cop this shoe, man. And that's just in my personal opinion right there. And before we, you know, get to the end of the video off, this is something that I've asked on lives before, and I asked like friends personally, and I want to bring it to you guys. And in the conversation below, let me know what you guys think. Now, this is my thing right here. If you have the Air Jordan 1 Black Toe and you have the Air Jordan 1 Chicagos, right? Now, a lot of people will actually go for the Chicagos before they go for the Black Toes. Now, we all know Chicago Air Jordan 1 sell significantly higher than, you know, than Black Toes. Like, you already know, Chicago 1s is going for $1,000+. Now, but this is where it gets a little confusing and a little tricky to me. Now, say if you take another shoe, say if you got a Court Purple 2.0 or whatever, right? Chicago color blocking and everything. Looks super dope, amazing. You know, a lot of the shoe sold out. People love the shoe. And then you go ahead and, I don't want to say fragments, because, you know, fragments, they have that hype behind the shoe. But if you take, you know, a Bred Toe, which pretty much has the black toe color blocking, a lot of people, you know, would choose Bred Toes over Court Purples. Or say if you have the Game Royal Air Jordan 1s, you know, with that Chicago Bulls colorway, except you replace the red with that Game Royal, and you had the Game Royals from this year, a lot of people would take the Game Royals from this year with that black toe color blocking over what they would take from, you know, the original Game Royals. It seems like, you know, every time we get a shoe that has the black toe color blocking, it actually resells for more, and it's actually more hyped than, you know, when we get a shoe with that Chicago color blocking. But it's crazy, because a Chicago will bring more hype than a black toe, and Chicagos actually sell more on the resale market than what black toes do. So in the conversation below, let me know, why do y'all think that is, you feel me? Because that's kind of weird to me, you feel me? Because honestly, I would personally think if people like the Chicagos more, I feel like that any other shoe that has that Chicago color blocking, people will actually rock with that shoe even more. But obviously, you know what I'm saying, your boy is wrong. It's really not going down like that. Like, people really rock with that black toe colorway, man. But in my personal opinion, the Chicago Air Jordan 1s, that is my favorite Air Jordan 1. But if we had to talk about what looks better, in my personal opinion, I do think the black toes look better than the Chicago 1s, man. So in my opinion, that's why I could kind of see why, you know what I'm saying, the black toes, you know, when they're not in the OG colorway, when you see that color blocking, more people go for them. But at the same time, if an OG Chicago release and an OG Black Toe release, I know people will probably go for the Chicagos first, just based off the history of that shoe right there, and you know what that shoe means to the culture. Not saying that the Black Toes don't mean anything to the culture, anything like that. It's just not as, it's not up there like that with the Chicagos, you feel what I'm saying? But that's just my personal opinion right there, man. Enough of me rambling, bro. Let me know how y'all feel about these Air Jordan 1 Mochas in the conversation below. Is this a cop? Is this a drop, man? Or is this for the toe? Is this for the collection? Are you good on this shoe because you already have the Travis Scott's? Do you even have the Travis Scott's? Do you think this shoe actually looks better than the Travis Scott's? And like I said before, all hype to the side. Do you really feel like this shoe looks better than the Travis Scott, man? Please let me know this in the conversation below. But I just want to say I greatly appreciate y'all, man. Make sure you keep on liking and subscribing to the page. Keep on supporting the movement, man. I'm telling y'all, I really do appreciate it. I do not take it for granted at all, man. So make sure y'all stay safe, man. Y'all stay blessed out there. Justice for George Floyd, as always, man. Always got to put that out there, bro. For real, for real. And y'all already know how we finna end the video off, man. If you search for good, you shall find a favor. If you search for evil, it shall find you. Proverbs 11:27. And we walk in faith and not by sight. For what is seen is temporary, what is unseen is forever. I live by that. I stand by that, man. Always, forever, man. I love y'all. Y'all stay blessed. Y'all stay safe. And it's your boy, 1127 Kicks. And always remember, bless your people, son.
Who done hit me up and told me shit on these niggas? Tell these niggas out here came at you, going showing the difference. Keep on dropping all of that shit that made these four wanna listen. You know these niggas ain't fucking telling. Get out of here.